everyone, Monisha here. In this video, I will be completing from question number 4 to question 11 of exercise 10.3. In my previous video, I had completed question 2 and 3, where we had simplified by using formula method and factorization. So in this video, statement problems will be given. Again, we can factorize it, or else we can use the formula to do the problem. Okay? Hope this session will be good and interesting for you. So please watch till the end. Let us start the session. Moving on to the fourth question. The first three questions I have done in my previous video. So this one is the fourth one. So the question is, the sum of the reciprocals of Rahman's age in years, 3 years ago and 5 years from now is 1/3. Find his present age. Okay. So we don't know the present age of Rahman. So let his present age be X. Okay. So they have told 3 years ago. So 3 years ago, his age might be like X minus 3. The present age minus 3 years, right? And 5 years from now. 5 years from now means after 5 years. Okay. So 5 years from now, his age will be 5 times more than the present age. So this is the term. So they have given the sum of the reciprocals of Rahman's age. Okay, the sum of the reciprocals. Reciprocal is, one is 3 years ago, sum means plus symbol, and X plus 5. Okay, the sum of reciprocals of Rahman's age 3 years ago and 5 years from now. So this reciprocal is equal to 1/3. Okay, so this is the information they have given in the question. So we have to find out what is his present age. Okay. So we have to simplify it, that is X plus 5 plus X minus 3, X minus 3 into X plus 5. So what happens is, so these two denominator will become the LCM. So by considering the first term, here X minus 3, X minus 3 get cancels. So remaining is X plus 5 here, X plus 5 into 1 is X plus 5 itself. In the same way, in the second term, X plus 5 get cancels. The remaining will be X minus 3. X minus 3 into 1 will be X minus 3 itself. Okay? Is equal to 1/3. Next, we need to simplify it. Here, X plus 5 plus X minus 3. Okay? So, whole divided by, we can multiply this one. X into X plus 5 minus 3 into X plus 5 is equal to 1/3. Here, plus X plus X. Plus 1X plus 1X will become 2X. Plus 5 minus 3. So 5 minus 3 is 2. Divide by X into X is X square. X into 5 is 5X. Minus 3X. Next, minus into plus, minus 3 5s are 15. Is equal to 1/3. So next, write the numerator as it is. 2X plus 2 whole divided by X square. Here plus into minus minus. 5X minus 3X is 2X minus 15. Is equal to 1/3. Next, what we have to do, we need to cross multiply it, okay? That is, we need to multiply 3 into 2x plus 2. Next, 1 into this equation will become the same, okay? So 3 2s are 6x plus 3 2s are 6 is equal to x square plus 2x minus 15. In the next step, I will be taking, shifting these two terms to right hand side. So it will become x square plus 2x. When I shift 6x this side, it will become minus 6x minus 15. When I shift plus 6 here, it will become minus 6. Okay. So x square plus and minus. Unlike sign means we need to subtract it. So 6 minus 2 is 4x. Larger number sign is minus. Here minus minus. Like sign means we need to add it. So 15 plus 6 will be 21. And larger number sign is minus. Okay. Now, we need to take the two middle terms. When we multiply it, we have to get this 21. When we add or subtract, we have to get 4. So the number is minus 7x plus 3x. 7 3s are 21, 7 minus 3 is 4, right? So this is the two numbers, okay? 7 3s are 21, minus 7 plus 3 will be minus 4x, okay? Next, we need to take the common terms. So here, the common term is x. When I take x common, remaining will be x minus 7. In the next term, 3 is common, so the remaining will be x minus 7. So 1 is x minus 7 and the one is x plus 3. Okay, so x minus, now we have to separately equate it to 0. So x plus 3 is equal to 0, x is equal to 7 and x is equal to minus 3. We know that age can't be negative, so x is 7. So the present age of, therefore present age of Rahman is 7 years. Present age of Rahman is 7 years. I hope you understood this. Moving on to the fifth question of this session. In a class test, the sum of Shefali's marks in mathematics and English is 30. So the total marks obtained by Shefali in maths and English both, the total marks is 30, but we don't know the individual marks of maths and English. Okay, so let the marks of mathematics be x, okay, so let the marks of mathematics be x. We know that the total marks is 30. If 1 is x, the other will be 30 minus x, right? Total minus the marks of mathematics. So let marks in write it in here. So in English be 30 minus x. Okay, so the marks in mathematics is x, the total marks is 30, so and the number will be 30 minus x. Fair enough. Next, had she got two more marks in mathematics, okay, so in the question they have given two more marks in mathematics. If she get two more marks in maths, then what will happen? The marks is taken as x. If two more marks means x plus 2, and three marks less in English, if she might got 3 marks less in English. So we have assumed the marks as 30 minus x. They have given 3 marks less. Then what will happen? It will become 27 minus x. Okay. If it happens, if 2 more marks in English, sorry, in maths, and 3 marks less in English means, then the product of the marks will become 210. If the product of these two marks will become 610. So will become 210. Okay, so we need to find out the individual marks. What is the marks of mathematics she got and what is the marks in English she got. Okay, we need to multiply it and solve it. So x into 27 minus x plus 2 into 27 minus x is equal to 210. Okay, so x into 27 is 27x minus x into x is x squared plus 2 into 27 is 54 minus 2 into x is 2x. So I'll be shifting this 210 to left hand side, it will become minus 210. So next we need to group it. Minus x square plus 27x minus 2x plus 54 minus 210 is equal to 0. Since negative sign is there, I will be taking common of it. So it will become x square minus 27x plus 2x minus 54 plus 210 is equal to 0. Okay, so it will become x square minus into plus is minus. So 27 minus 2 will be 25x, larger number sign is minus here. So next, minus into plus is minus, 210 minus 54. So it will become 10 minus 4 is 6, 20 minus 5 is 15. So 156. So larger number sign is plus, so plus 156 is equal to 0. Now we have to solve this equation. So while solving, we can do it either by factorization or we can do it by using formula method. Okay. So here I will be doing by using formula method. Here this is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. So a will be 1, b will be minus 25 and c is 156. You can either do it by factorization or by using formula method. It's of your choice. Okay. So the formula is x is equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2a. Okay, so x is equal to, so here in b a negative sign is there, in the formula also a negative sign is there, so we had to write minus of minus 25 plus or minus square root of minus 25 whole square minus 4ac, that is 4 into a is 1 and c is 156, whole divided by 2a, that is 2 into 1. Okay, so next x is equal to minus into minus plus 25 plus or minus square root of 25 square, minus 25 square is 625 minus 156 into 4. So 4 6 are 24, 2 carry, 4 5 is 20, 22, 2 carry, 4 1s are 4, 5 6, that is 624. 624 divided by 2 1s are 2. So x is equal to 25 plus or minus 20, 625 minus 624 is root 1 divided by 2. So 25 plus or minus root 1 is also equal to 1 divided by 2. Now we can split into two form, that is x is equal to 25 plus 1 by 2, and the one is x is equal to 25 minus 1 by 2. Okay, so it will become x is equal to 26 by 2, that is 13, x is equal to 13 is one answer, and x is equal to, this is 25 minus 1 by 2 is 24 by 2, that is 12. So the value of x, that is the marks in maths, is 13 or 12. Okay, so therefore marks in mathematics, so mathematics is either 13 or 12. Okay, so if it is 13 or 12, then what happens? Therefore marks in English will be, so marks in English is, in the first case, if we take x is equal to 13, then it is 27 minus x, right? So 27 minus x, that is 27 minus 13, so it will be 14. The marks in English will be 14. Or in the second case, if you take x is equal to 12, then 27 minus 12, so that will be 15. Okay, so the marks in mathematics will be either 13 or 12, and the marks in English will be either 14 or 15. Okay, I hope you understood this. Moving on to the sixth question. The sixth question is the diagonal of a rectangular field. So consider this as a rectangular field, and the diagonal of a rectangular field is 60 meter more than the shortest side. So let us consider this as a shorter side. So this is a shorter side, right, in a rectangle. So let us take this shortest side as x. Okay, so let the shorter side be x. Okay, let the shorter side be x. Then what they have told is the diagonal of a rectangle is 60 meter more than the shorter side. So this is the diagonal. The diagonal is 60 meter more than the shorter side. Okay, so diagonal. So let us consider this as A, B, C and D. So diagonal AC is equal to 60 plus x, because it is 60 meter more than the shorter side. Next, if the longer side, so this is the longer side, the longer side is 30 meter more than the shorter side. So this longer side is 30 meter more than the shorter side. So longer side. So longer side is AB. Okay, and this shorter side is BC. Okay, AB is 30 plus x. Now you can see here, we have to find out the values of all the sides. Okay, the length of all the side, we have to find it out. Now you can see here, it is in a shape of a right angle triangle. Here in a rectangle, this is 90 degree, right? Okay, this is 90 degree and this is 90 degree. So if it is 90 degree, then this will form a right angle triangle. So if this is a right angle triangle, then we can apply Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so by Pythagoras theorem, here this will be the diagonal. So this will be the diagonal. AC will be the diagonal. Okay, that is hypotenuse. So AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Okay, so AC is 60 plus x. So 60 plus x whole square is equal to ab. Ab is 30 plus x whole square plus bc is x square. Okay, so 60 plus a square is in the form of a plus b whole square formula. That is a square plus b square plus 2ab. That is 2 into a into b. In the same way, this is also in the form of a plus b whole square. That is 30 square, that is a square, and x square, that is in the form of b square, plus 2 into a into b, plus x square, right as it is. Okay, now 6 square is, what is 6 square? 6 6 is 36. So 60 square will be 3600. Okay, so 1 0 is there, if you square it will become 2 zeros. Okay, plus x square, plus 2 6 is 12. So 2 into 60 is 120x is equal to 3 square is 9. So 30 square is 900 plus x square plus 2 3 is 6. So 60x plus x square. Okay, so here x square and x square get cancels. So we can take everything to one side. Here 3600 minus 900 plus 120x minus 60x minus x square is equal to 0. So 3600 minus 900 will be 2700 plus 20x minus 60x is 60x, 120x minus 60x, next is minus x square. Okay, so this will be in the form of x minus x square plus 60x plus 2700. Since minus sign comes in the starting point, we can take the common of it. So we will get this equation. So minus get cancels. Now we have to take two values, so two middle term, so that when we multiply it, it has to be 2700, and when we add or subtract, it has to be 60. So 2700 is a larger number, just reduce it to 27. Okay, so 27, just assume it is 27 or 6. Okay, so by doing 9 3 is 27, by multiplying 9 3 is 27. Okay, 9 3 is 27 and 9 minus 3 is 6. Just put two more zeros to that. So 900 into 300, 9 3 is 27. So 900 into 300 is 2700. Okay, see here, 900 into 300. So this will be 2700. So next, 900 sorry 90 into 30. Okay, so 90 into 30 is 2700, and 90 minus 30 is 60. Okay, so 90 minus 30 is 60. So we can write in that form, that is minus 90x plus 30x minus 2700. So 9 3 is 27, 90 into 30 is 2700. Next, 90 minus 30 is 60. Next, we have to take common for this. Okay, so here x is common, the remaining will be x minus 90. Here 30 is common, so x minus 90. So first term is x minus 90 and the second term is x plus 30. So here we need to equate it separately to 0. So we will get x is equal to 90, which is a positive number, and here x is equal to minus 30. The length of a rectangle will not be in negative sign. So we have to take this x is equal to 90 as our answer. So the shortest side, or the shorter side, so the shorter side is given by the variable x, which is equal to 90 meters. So next is the diagonal. So diagonal AC is equal to 60 plus x, so that is 60 plus 90, so it is 150 meters. So next one is longer side. So longer side is AB, that is 30 more than the shorter side. So 30 plus 90 is equal to 120. Okay, so 120 meters. So I hope you understood this. So one is shorter side is x, and diagonal is AC, and next one is longer side is 120. I hope you understood. Moving on to the seventh problem. The seventh question is, the difference of the squares of two numbers is 180. The square of a smaller number is 8 times the larger number. Find the two numbers. So there are two numbers, one is smaller and larger, whereas we don't know two of them. Okay, so let the smaller number be 1, and let the larger number be x. Okay, so let the smaller number be y and let the larger number be x. So now the difference of squares of two numbers, the difference of squares of two numbers is 180. Okay, so the difference means minus squares of two numbers. So why I am taking x square first means it is the larger number. So during subtraction we have to take larger number first, right? So x square minus y square, the difference of squares of two numbers is equal to 180 as per the question. Next, the square of the smaller number, we know that the smaller number is y. Okay, the square of the smaller number is 8 times the larger number. Okay, so it is as per the question. The difference of square of two numbers is equal to 190, and the square of the smaller number is 8 times the larger number. So let this be equation 1 and this be equation 2. So now instead of this y square, we can substitute this value, right? So substitute equation 2 in equation 1. Okay, so equation 1 is x square minus y square is equal to 180. So instead of this y square, we can write 8x here. So x square minus 8x, I'll be shifting 180 this side, minus 180 is equal to 0. So now it is in the form of a quadratic equation. So now what we have to do, we need to multiply the extreme terms. So 180 into x square is 180 x square. So we have to take two middle terms. When we multiply those middle terms, we have to get 180. When we add or subtract, we have to get 8. So which are those two numbers? So that is 18 tens. Okay, so 18 tens are 180. 18 minus 10 is 8, right? Since there is a negative sign here, I am taking minus 18 plus 10x, because larger number sign we have to retain, right? So the two numbers are 18 into 10, 18 and 10. 18 tens are 180, 18 minus 10 is 8, right? So next we have to take the common numbers from the group of 2. So here x is common, the remaining will be x minus 18. Here 10 is common, so x minus 18 is remaining. So two terms we will get, one is x minus 18 and the one is x plus 10. Okay, so now we have to separately equate it to 0. One is x minus 18 is equal to 0 and the one is x plus 10 is equal to 0. So here x is equal to 18, so and the one is x is equal to minus 10, the number is negative. So I will be taking 18 here. So now we have to get both the numbers, right? So x is equal to 18 is one number. We know that y square is equal to 8x from equation 2, right? So y square is equal to 8 into 18. Okay, so y square is equal to 18 8s are 144. So y is equal to square root of 144. So the square root of 144 is 12. Okay, so the value of x is, the larger number is 18 and smaller number is 12. Okay, we can write it as it is, that is smaller number. So smaller number is y is equal to 12 and larger number, so larger number is x is equal to 18. Okay, I hope you understood this. Moving on to the eighth problem. The eighth problem is a train travels 360 km at a uniform speed. So we don't know the speed here. So let the speed be x. Okay, so let the speed be x kilometer per hour. So next, a train travels 360 km. So total distance So total distance of train or total distance traveled by train is 360 kilometer. Okay, total distance traveled by train is 360 kilometer. Now a train travels 360 kilometer uniform speed if the speed had been 5 kilometer more. So if speed is 5 kilometer per hour more. Okay, if this is the case, we know that the uniform speed we have assumed as x. If it is 5 kilometer more, means it is x plus 5 speed. Okay, 5 kilometer per hour more. So it would have been taken 1 hour less. If this is the case, if the speed is 5 kilometer more, then what would be the initial distance for it? So it will become minus 1 hour less. Okay, it will become minus 1 hour less to reach the journey. So they had asked to find out the speed of the train. Okay, they have asked to find out the speed of the train here. So now in physics, you might have known this formula, that is speed is equal to distance by time. Okay, we have assumed speed as x, so we can interchange it, that is time is equal to distance by speed. So distance by speed. Here, first is a train travels 360 km at uniform speed. Okay, so what it will become? In the first case, a train travels 360 km at a uniform speed. So distance by speed. So next, if it takes 5 km per hour more, so then it will become 360 by x plus 5, 5 km more. Next, the question is, so if it takes 5 km hour more, then 5 km per hour more, then the whole journey will be reduced to 1 hour, 1 hour less than the usual time taken. Okay, so we have to write this in an equation form. That is, when the speed of the train increased by 5 km, then whatever time taken to reach the usual journey will become 1 hour less. Okay, so this is the form of the equation. Next, what we have to do, we need to shift it this side. So 360 x plus 5 minus 360 by x is equal to minus 1. So next we have to calculate it. Okay, so just by cross multiplying, we will get 360 x minus 360 into x plus 5 whole divided by x into x plus 5 is equal to minus 1. Okay, so next we need to take out, multiply this which are in the bracket, that is 360x minus into plus minus 360x minus into plus minus, so 5 into 0 0 5 6 are 30, 3 carry, 5 3 are 15, 16 17 and 18, 1800. Okay, so next x into x is x square plus x into 5, 5x is equal to minus 1. Here plus 360x and minus 360x get cancels. Okay, remaining is minus 1800 divided by x square plus 5x is equal to minus 1. Next we have to cross multiply it, so it will become minus 1800 is equal to minus x square and minus 5x. So I'll be shifting these two to left hand side. It will become plus x square plus 5x minus 1800 as it is equal to 0. So next we have to factorize it, so that we have to get the value for x, that is the speed. Okay, so now we need to take two middle terms, so that when we multiply it, we have to get 1800, when we add or subtract, we have to get 5. So for that, we have to take the LCM of this. I will be writing this LCM here. Okay, so 1800, so 2 9s are, 2 9s are 18, so 2 4s are 8, 1 carry, 2 5s are 10, 2 50, so 2 2s are 4, is 225, so here 2 is not possible to divide from 2, so 3, so 3 7s are 21, 1 carry, 3 5s are 15, so here 3 2s are 6, 1 carry, 3 5s are 15, so 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 3s are 24, so 24 into 3, 72, so it's not possible, so So 5, 5s are 25. Now we have to group this so that when we multiply that, we have to get 1800. When we add or subtract, we have to get 5. Okay. 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 5s are 40, 3 3s are 9, 9 5s are 45. Okay, see here, 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, and 8 5s are 40. So this is one group of number, and the one is 3 3s are 9, 9 5s are 45. So the two number is 40 and 45. So when we multiply 40 into 45, so 4 5s are 20, 4 4s are 16, 17, 18. We will get 1800. When we subtract 45 minus 40, we will get 5. So 40 and 45 are the two numbers. Okay. So x square plus 45x minus 40x minus 1800 is equal to 0. So here, when we take common, x will be common here. Remaining will be x plus 45. Here minus 40 is common. We will get x plus 45. Is equal to 0. Here x plus 45 and the one is x minus 40 is equal to 0. We need to equate it separately to 0 now. X is equal to minus 45. Speed can't be negative, so we can discard this. So x minus 40 is equal to 0, x is equal to 40. So the uniform speed of train is 40 km per hour. So therefore, uniform speed of train is 40 km per hour. I hope you understood this. Moving on to the ninth question. The ninth question is, two water taps together can fill a tank in 9 3 by 8 hours. The tap of larger diameter takes 10 hours less than the smaller one to fill a tank. Okay, a tap of larger diameter takes 10 hours less to fill a tank completely compared to the smaller one. So find the time taken by each tap separately to fill a tank completely. Okay, so now time taken by the, I have written the data already. So time taken by the smaller tap to fill the tank. So time taken by the smaller tap to fill the tank, we don't know how much hours it takes. So let it be x hours. So time taken by the smaller tap to fill the tank completely, let it be x hours. We know that the larger tap takes 10 hours less compared to smaller tank. So let the larger tap takes x minus 10 hours. X is the hours taken by, the time taken by the smaller tap. So whereas the larger tap takes 10 hours less than that. Okay. So now x hours is the time taken by the smaller tap to fill the tank completely. Okay. To fill the tank completely, it takes x hours. But for 1 hour, it fills the part of the tank. So that part of the tank is 1 by x. Okay. X hours for completely filling the tank. Whereas for 1 hour, the tank will be like half filled, right? So half filled. That is 1 by x part is filled. So for larger tap, in the same way, it takes 1 by x minus 10 to fill the tank. Okay. To fill the tank. 1 by x part will be filled. Now, as per the question, the total time taken by both the taps to fill the tank completely is 9 3 by 8, which is in the mixed fraction form. So we have to convert it into proper fraction. So 8 9s are 72. 72 plus 3 is 75 by 8. So 75 by 8 hours. So this is the total time taken by both the taps to fill the tank completely. Okay. So now we have to find out the time taken by each tap separately to fill the tank. Okay. So one is 1 by x plus 1 by x minus 10. Both the tank completely fills the tank at hours 75 by, sorry, it has to be written in reciprocal form since we have taken the hours in the denominator. So 1 by 75 by 8. Okay. So when I take the reciprocal of it, it will become 1 by x plus 1 by x minus 10 is equal to, the reciprocal 8 will go to the numerator and 75 in the denominator, right? So next, if I take LCM as x into x minus 10, so here in the first term, xx get cancels, the remaining is x minus 10. So x minus 10 into 1 will be x minus 10 plus. In the second term, x minus 10 get cancels. So x into 1 is x is equal to 8 by 75. Okay. Here plus x will be 2x minus 10 divided by x into x is x squared minus x into 10 is 10x is equal to 8 by 75. So next we can cross multiply it. So 2x minus 10 into 75. So I am multiplying this 75 with 2x minus 10 is equal to 8 into, I am multiplying this one. Okay, 8 into x squared minus 10x. Okay, so we need to multiply this 75 into 2. So 2 5s are 10, 2 7s are 14. So 150x minus 10 into 75 is 750 is equal to 8 into x squared is 8x squared minus 8 into 10 is 80x. So now I will be shifting the terms which are in the right side to the, sorry, left side to the right hand side. Okay, so it will become 8x squared minus 80x. So when I shift 150 here, it will become minus 150x. So 750 minus 750 become plus 750 is equal to 0. Okay, so 8x squared here 230x and plus 750 is equal to 0. So divide throughout by 2. Okay, so 2 4s are 2 115s are 375. Okay, so this is the equation. We will continue it. That is 4x square minus 115x plus 375 is equal to 0. So this is the quadratic equation which is obtained. So this is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. So here I will be using quadratic formula. Okay. So the quadratic equation we got is 4x square minus 115x plus 375 is equal to 0. So this is in the form of standard form of quadratic equation, that is ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Here a is 4, b is minus 115 and c is 375. So we can apply quadratic formula now. X is equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2a. So x is equal to minus of b is minus 115. So minus 115 plus or minus square root of b is minus 115 whole square minus 4ac, that is 4 into a is 4 and c is 375. So whole divided by 2a, a is 4. Okay, so x is equal to minus into minus plus 115 plus or minus square root of, it is 115 whole square. Okay, we need to multiply 115 twice. So 5 5s are 25, 2 carry, 5 1s are 5, 6 7, 5 1s are 5. Next 115 and 115, because 1 1s are, we need to do that. So 5 12 12 3 and 1. So 1 3 2 2 5. So minus 115 whole square is equal to 1 3 2 2 5 minus 4 4s are 16, 16 into 375. So 375 into 16. So 6 5s are 30, 6 7s are 42, 43, 44, 45, 6 3s are 18, 6 3s are 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. Okay. So 375 here, 0, 10 and 6, 6000. Okay. Here it is 6000. Whole divided by 2 4s are 8. So next we need to subtract 13,225 to 6,000. Okay. So it will be 7,225. So x is equal to 115 plus or minus square root of 7,225 whole divided by 8. So now we need to find out the square root of 7,225. In order to find out this square root, we have to group it like two numbers. Okay, so here 8 8s are 64, 9 9s are 81, which will be bigger number than 72. So I'm taking 8 8s are 64. Okay. Next we need to add the same number whichever we have taken in the divisor. Okay. 8 plus 8 is 16. So next we have to like usual division. In usual division we take only one numbers, but in square root we have to take in pairs. Okay. So when we subtract it, it will become 825. So now we have to put one number here and the same number we have to write it here, and then we have to multiply it. Okay, I will be taking 5. So 5 5s are 25. So 5 6 are 30 plus 2 32. So 5 1s are 5 and 8 825. So the square root of 7 2 to 5 is 85. Okay, so x is equal to 115 plus or minus 85 whole divided by 8. So x is equal to 115. We can group it two times. In the first case we can take plus, in the second case we can take minus. So plus 85 whole divided by 8 in the first case. So next one, x is equal to 115 minus 85 whole divided by 8. Okay, so x is equal to, so it will become, so 200 divided by 8 in the first case, and the second case it will become 30 divided by 8. So here four twos are and four fives are, two ones are, two 25s are. Here eight threes are 24, six carry point, 8 7s are 56 and 8 5s are 40. So x is equal to 25 is one answer and x is equal to 3.75. okay, this is the second one. So what happens, time taken by the tap, the time taken by the smaller tap, okay, the time taken by smaller tap is 25 hours to fill the tank completely. Okay, therefore time taken by smaller tap to fill the tank completely is equal to 25 hours. So next one is time taken by larger tap to fill the tank completely. We know that the larger tank takes 10 hours less than the smaller tank, right? So the smaller tank takes 25 hours, so minus 10 is 15 hours. So the smaller tap takes 25 hours whereas the larger tap takes 15 hours. So this is the way of doing this problem. Moving on to the 10th problem. An express train takes 1 hour less than the passenger train to travel 132 km between Mysore and Bangalore. So without taking into consideration the time they stop at the intermediate stations, if the average speed of the express train is 11 km per hour more than that of the passenger train, find the average speed of the two trains. So we don't know the average speed of both the passenger train and the express train, but we know one thing, that is the average speed of the express train is 11 km per hour more than that of the passenger train. Okay, so let speed of passenger train be x kilometer per hour and let speed of express train B x plus 11, that is more than 11 km per hour more than that of the passenger train. So x plus 11 km per hour. Okay, so next the total distance is 132 km. Okay, the total distance is 132 kilometer between Mysore and Bangalore. So here an express train takes 1 hour less than the passenger train to travel. Okay, so when the express train takes 11 kilometer per hour more. Okay, so the distance is 132, whereas this is speed. According to the formula, speed is equal to distance by time. So speed is equal to distance by time. So time is equal to distance by speed. So this is distance and this is speed. So when the express train takes 11 kilometer per hour more than that of the passenger train, so the time taken by the express train is 1 hour less, 1 hour less to cover the same distance as that of the passenger train. So when the speed is 11 kilometer per hour more than the passenger train, then this express train takes 1 hour less compared to that of the passenger train. So that is this equation considered. Okay, so 132 by x plus 11, we have to shift it here. So minus 132 by x is equal to minus 1. Okay, so here by taking LCM, we will get 132x minus 132 into x plus 11 whole divided by x into x plus 11 is equal to minus 1. So here 132x minus 132x minus into plus is minus 132 into 11. So 132 into 11, it will be 1452. Okay, so 1452 whole divided by x square plus 11x is equal to minus 1. We need to cross multiply it. Okay, here plus 132x minus 132x get cancels. Remaining is 14. So 1452 whole divided by, so we can cross multiply this one. So minus 1 into x square is minus x square minus 11x. So I'll be shifting these terms to left hand side. It will become plus x square plus 11x. I'll be keeping this 1452 here itself. Okay, now it is in the form of a quadratic equation, that is ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Here a is equal to 1, b is equal to 11, and c is equal to minus 1452. Fine, we can apply quadratic formula, that is minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2a. Okay, so x is equal to minus b. Minus b is 11 plus or minus square root of minus b square, that is 11 square, sorry, b square minus 4ac. 4 into a into c is minus 1452. Okay, into 2a. 2 into a is 1. Okay, so next x is equal to minus 11 plus or minus square root of, here 11 square is 121, minus into minus is plus, so 4 2s are 8, 4 5s are 20, 4 4s are 16, 17 18, 4 1s are 4 and 5, 5 8 0 8 whole divided by 2 into 1 is 2. Okay, so next x is equal to minus 11 plus or minus square root of 5 8 0 8 plus 121, so it will be 9 2 9 5 5 9 2 9 5 9 2 9 whole divided by 2. Okay, so we need to find out the value of square root of 5 9 2 9. So 5 9 2 9, in order to find out the value, we have to group it in pairs. Okay, so here 6 6 are 36, 7 7 are 49, 8 8 are 64, which is more than, a larger number than 59. So we can take 7 7 are 49. Okay, the same number we have to add it here. So 7 plus 7 is 14. So here it will be 10. In this division, we have to take the numbers in group. Okay, we have to take both the numbers, 29. So let us take 9 here. If I take 9, so it will become 149. So 9 into 9 here. Okay, so 9 9s are 81, 9 4s are 36. So 37, 30, 39, 40 and 44. So 9 1s are 9, 1 3. So it will be even more than 109. So I will be taking 7. Okay, 7 7s are 49, 7 4s are 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 7 1s are 7 plus 3, 10. Okay, So the square root of 5929 is 77. So x is equal to minus 11 plus or minus 77 by 2. Now we can separate it. X is equal to minus 11 plus 77 by 2 and x is equal to minus 11 minus 77 by 2. Okay. So x is equal to, here it will be 66 divided by 2. It is 33 and x is equal to minus 88 divided by 2. That is minus 44. The speed can't be negative. So the speed is x is equal to 33. So which is the uniform speed of a passenger train. Okay. Therefore, we can write it here. Speed of passenger train. So speed of passenger train is x is equal to 33 km per hour. Next, speed of express train. So which is 11 km per hour more than that of the passenger train. Okay. Speed of express train. So speed of express train, which is 11 km per hour more. So 33 plus 11, that is 44 km per hour. Okay, I hope you understood this. Moving on to the last question of this session. The last question is sum of the areas of the two squares. Okay, let us consider two squares where sum of the areas of the two squares is equal to 468. We know that area of a square. So area of a square is given by side square. Okay, so side square, in square 1 the side is x, so the area will be x square. In square 2 the side is y, so the area will be y square. So sum of the areas of two squares. Okay, sum means plus sum of the areas of two squares is equal to 468. Let it be equation number 1. Next, the difference of the perimeters of the two square. So perimeter is the side. The perimeter of first square is 4x and the perimeter of the second square is 4y. Okay, the difference. Difference means minus. So the difference of the perimeter of the two square is equal to 24. Here 4 is common, so I will be taking it outside. So x minus y is equal to 24. 4 ones are 4, 6 are 24. So second x minus y is equal to 6. So x is equal to, I will be shifting minus y this side. So y plus 6. So let this be equation number 2. Okay. So I will be substituting this. Substituting equation 2 to 1. So substituting equation 2 in equation 1. The equation 1 is x square plus y square is equal to 468. Okay. So x in so here x is y plus 6. So I will be substituting y plus 6 in the place of x. So y square is equal to 468. So this is in the form of a plus b whole square. So a square b square plus 2ab plus y square is equal to 468. So here y square plus y square is 2y square plus 26 are 12y plus 6 square is 36. I will be shifting this 468 this side. Okay, so it will become 2y square plus 12y. So plus into minus, minus. So here, so 432 is equal to 0. So all the numbers are divisible by 2. So we can divide throughout by 2. Okay, 2 1s are 2, 6 are 2, 2s are 4, 2 1s are 2, 2 6 are 12. Okay, the equation will be y square plus 6y minus 2, 16. Okay, so now either we can apply the formula for quadratic formula or else we can factorize it. Okay, if we need to factorize it, means we have to take the LCM of it, that is 216. So 6 36 and 6 6. Okay, or else we can take formula for this also. Okay, if it is not possible, means we can take formula. So here 6, 6 6 are 36, minus 6 will not be 6. Either we can simplify it. Okay, so 2 8s are, so 2 5s are 10 and 2 4s are, 2 2s are 4, 2 7s are. Next is 3 9s are, so 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16, so 16 minus 9, so it will not be possible. So 3 3s are 1. Okay, so we'll get one group of number, that is, see here, 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12. Okay, next, 3 3s are 9, 9 2s are 18. So 18 and 12. So 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12, 2 3s are 6, 6 3s are 18. Here, 8 2s are 16, 9 and 12. So we'll get 216. If we multiply these two numbers, we'll get 216. When we subtract it, 18 minus 12 is 6. So 18 and 12 are the two numbers. Okay. So y square plus 18y minus 12y minus 216 is equal to 0. Okay. Here in first group, y is common. So remaining is y plus 18. In the second group, minus 12 is common. So the remaining is y plus 18 is equal to 0. So the two terms are, one is y plus 18 and the one is y minus 12 is equal to 0. We have to equate it separately. So y plus 18 is equal to 0. So y is equal to minus 18. The sides can't be negative, so we can reject it. So the second is y minus 12 is equal to 0. Y is equal to 12. So y is the side of the second square. We need to find the first one. So equation 2, I will substitute it. So x is equal to y plus 6. X is equal to y value is 12 plus 6, x is equal to 18. Okay, so the side of square 1, the side of square 1 is x is equal to 18 meters, and side of square 2, side of square 2 is y is equal to 12 meters. So this was the last question of this session. I hope you understood this, and thanks for watching my videos.